Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 98 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 168 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 169 and question 170. Question 169. You plan to automate the deployment of virtual machine skill set that uses the Windows Server 2016 data center image. You need to ensure that when the skill set virtual machines are provisioned, they have web server component installed. So it's talking about post deployment task. Which two actions should you perform? Option C, create an Azure policy. Azure policy helps to enforce organizational standards and to access compliance. Therefore, it cannot be the correct answer for post deployment task. Option B, create an automation account. Automation account is used to hold automation runbooks and configuration used for automating operations and management task. Therefore, it has nothing to do with the post deployment tasks. Now we are left with option A, D and E. Let's check option E, create new virtual machine scale set. Creating new virtual machine scale set is one of the tasks which we need to do, but it is not directly related to the server component installation. Therefore, it can be the correct answer as well. Now we are left with option A and option D, which are being used for custom scripts. The custom script extension downloads and executes scripts on Azure virtual machine. This extension is useful for post deployment configuration, software installation, or any other configuration management task. And it can work with the Azure Resource Manager template as well. The option A would be the first task, that we will upload a configuration script, and the option D would be the second task, which is the modify the extension profile section of the Azure Resource Manager template. Let's move to next question. Question 170. You onboard 10 Azure virtual machines to Azure Automation State Configuration. You need to use Azure Automation State Configuration to manage the ongoing consistency of virtual machine configurations. Which three actions should you perform in sequence? Let's go to learn.microsoft.com to understand it better. We are on Azure Automation State Configuration Overview page in learn.microsoft.com. We'll scroll down. Azure Automation State Configuration is an Azure configuration management service that allows you to write, manage, and compile PowerShell desired state configuration. Configurations for nodes in any cloud or on-premise data center. Let's scroll down. We'll go to get started with Azure Automation State Configuration. We are on get started with Azure Automation State Configuration page. We will scroll down. So first step here, we'll create a DSC configuration. So import a configuration into Azure Automation would be the first step. That means we can upload a configuration into Azure Automation. Then of course we can view configuration in Azure Automation. Then we can compile a configuration in Azure Automation. This would be the second step in our answer. And then we can view a compilation job. We can view node configurations. Enable an Azure Resource Manager virtual machine for management with state configuration. we can view the list of managed nodes. The third step is we can view the reports for managed nodes. And we can check the virtual machine consistency for if it is compliant or not. So this is our last step. Let's move back to question. Therefore, creating a management group is not one of the requirement, and assign tags to the virtual machine is not one of the requirement. The correct sequence is upload a configuration to Azure Automation State Configuration, then compile a configuration into a node configuration, and check the compliance status of the node. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.